Hello, I'm Matt, and in this video we're going to be making an instant ice cream maker. The way this works is pretty unique as far as ice cream makers go, as this top tray is super cooled by dumping the heat into the water surrounding it, allowing water, like you see here, to start freezing almost immediately and ice cream to be made in just a few minutes. Now this might sound a little bit complicated, but it's actually super simple to build. So before we start making some ice cream with this, here's how to construct one. So there are three main components we'll need for this build: a heatsink, a tray, and some Peltier elements. These Peltier elements are basically heat pumps. When electricity is applied, they shove heat from one side of the plate to the other. This process means that while one side is kept very cold, the other gets extremely hot, which is what the heatsink is for. This needs to be quite substantial in size, as it's got a lot of heat to contend with. As both of these items aren't something you're likely to find locally, I've placed international purchasing links to them in the description. As for the tray, it can be roughly the same size as the heatsink, and it needs to have a flat underside so that it touches the heatsink evenly. I'm just going to use a butter tray, but it's not too specific, so choose anything that you can find that's suitable. So the first thing to do is get some heat paste, add a blob of it to the heatsink, and then squash the Peltier elements down on top with the tech side facing upwards. Once they're all on, we can add yet more heat paste on top, and then squash on the tray itself, which can then be secured in place with cable ties. These need to be really tight for good thermal contact, so you may require the help of a clamp and pliers. Once this is done, we can tidy up the cables. To do this, we can simply thread one side through to the other and group them by colour. With that done, the last thing to do is sort out the power supply. As all six Peltier elements draw about 400 watts, we need to use a pretty beefy power source. Luckily, computer power supplies have been able to deliver this kind of power for a long time, so you should be able to pick up a second-hand unit for very little money. I happen to have a 1000-watt server PSU on hand, so I'm going to be using this instead. The power supply's 12-volt output can simply be hooked up to the Peltier elements, with red being positive and black being negative. I'm using an XT60 connector in between so that they can be disconnected easily. Now, if you do use a standard computer power supply like I mentioned earlier, you can find a guide on how to wire it up in the description. So now we're ready to try it out. Now, as you might have noticed, this channel is called DIY Perks and not Cooking Perks, so I'm not actually that great at cooking, so we'll see how this goes. Thankfully, the recipe does appear to be quite simple, so even I might not mess it up. So the first thing to do is get some whipped cream. This is like, well, we're going to whip this cream. This is double cream, so we'll empty about half of it into a bowl. Ah, that's a lot of cream. I'll go with a quarter for now, actually. Don't want to make too much. And just use a whisker to whisk it. Now, you could obviously do this by hand, but I can't be bothered to wait for that, so we'll just use modern technology for now. Right, so I think that's done. So that means we need to add about 100 grams of sweetened condensed milk. This is all very approximate, really. It's not very precise. So we've got like a quarter of this, which is a 397 gram can, and a quarter of that, which is a 600 milliliter can. Oh dear, this is making such a mess. That's part of the fun. So we'll again just mix this together. So that should be the base of the ice cream, and to this we can add pretty much any flavour we like. So I'm just going to add a bit of vanilla to the flavouring, to add some flavour. So now that that's all mixed in with the flavouring, it's time to put it in the ice cream maker itself. So I'll just move these to one side. So before this gets turned on, we need to add the water. Because obviously this heatsink is going to get incredibly hot, and that heat needs to go somewhere, so it gets basically dumped into this water. So we need to just fill the whole thing up to about the top of the heatsink, and now we can add the ice cream mixture to the tray. and plug it in. So now what's going to happen is this tray is going to get really cool and hopefully freeze the ice cream mixture. Okay, so this has been going for about 2 minutes now, and as you can see, that's pretty frozen. The top's still a bit squishy, but the actual underneath is really quite ice creamy, so that's really good. I'll just spread that out a bit, give it an extra minute, and hopefully it'll be ready. Okay, so that's looking good. That's pretty solid. So now it's time to put it into the bowl, and this needs to be done extremely quickly, as the heat from the heatsink will very quickly transfer into the ice cream if I'm not fast enough. So, we'll just unplug it. And boom. So I've only made a tiny amount, as you can see, but not bad. Now, texture-wise, it's not going to be exactly the same as proper churned ice cream, but taste-wise, it does taste really good, quite rich and flavoursome. And one of the best advantages of being able to make ice cream so quickly is you can actually experiment a lot with the flavour. For example, earlier I tried making some carrot ice cream, which actually tasted pretty good. You could even use it to make some ice in under 5 minutes if you want to cool down your drink, which is pretty cool as well. Now, I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's been quite fun for me to make, because it's been quite different. Other than that, I'm Matt, and you've been watching DIY Perks. I hope I see you next time. If you'd like to see another of my projects, then why not check out how to make this super smooth camera slider, which is a fantastic way of getting really cinematic camera shots on the cheap. Alternatively, why not check out another project involving Peltier elements, this time using them to generate electricity and charge a phone. They're both worth a watch, so I hope you enjoy them.